concerning the order of rank. What is it that constitutes the mediocrity of the typical man? That he does not understand that things necessarily have their other side, that he combats evil conditions as if they could be dispensed with, that he will not take the one with the other, that he would fain obliterate and erase the specific character of a thing, of a circumstance, of an age, and of a person by calling only a portion of their qualities good and suppressing the remainder. The desirability of the mediocre is that which we others combat. Their ideal is something which shall no longer contain anything harmful, evil, dangerous, questionable, and destructive. We recognize the reverse of this, that with every growth of man, his other side must grow as well. That the highest man, if such a concept be allowed, would be that man who would represent the antagonistic character of existence most strikingly, and would be its glory and its only justification. Ordinary men may only represent a small corner and nook of this natural character. They perish the moment the multifariousness of the elements composing them and the tension between their antagonistic traits increases. But this is the prerequisite for greatness in man. That man should become better and at the same time more evil is my formula for this inevitable fact. Majority of people are only piecemeal and fragmentary examples of man. Only when all these creatures are jumbled together does one whole man arise. Whole ages and whole peoples in this sense have a fragmentary character about them. It may perhaps be part of the economy of human development that man should develop himself only piecemeal. But for this reason, one should not forget that the only important consideration is the rise of the synthetic man. That inferior men, and by far the great majority of people, are but rehearsals and exercises out of which here and there a whole man may arise. A man who is a human milestone and who indicates how far mankind has advanced up to a certain point. Mankind does not advance in a straight line. Often a type is attained which is again lost. For instance, with all the efforts of 300 years, we have not reached the men of the Renaissance again. And in addition to this, we must not forget that the man of the Renaissance was already behind his brother of classical antiquity.